Journal entry 169. For the first time, all the past 2 years, all of my theories were always rejected by every government agencies. Every single government agencies, not a single one believed in me. But now, I'm proven to be right. As I see in my footage as I woke up, I saw a solar flare. Yes, yes, a solar flare. Alright, the worst thing is, the solar flare that comes into the Earth, as it reaches the atmosphere, it'll detonate an EMP, or so we call an electron magnetic pulse, which will short circuit every single technology that we have on the planet right now, which is we have advanced.
Lord President, excuse me. We have something to tell you.
We have a report of an upcoming solar flare. It will affect everything you have.
What? No! This is heresy!
But ma'am, it will affect everything you have, including the water source, the food supply, and the air. It will also affect the reproduction of human species.
No, I refuse to believe this.
ISS-R International Space Station came on hold. Good morning, America. Breaking news. ISS astronaut material sustained that there will be a solar flare this year was considered to be a fraud, for there was a big loophole in the Discoverer area.
You're doing this for your own good.
Due to this, you will lose all the technology that you control.
You will lose your money.
I don't accept this.
Where's the computer?
It's there!
Carl, do the hack now!
Is there something you can do to help?
The enormous situation.
No, we don't.
The survival of the humanity is at risk. But wait, are you on top of it?
Yes.
We at S.P.E.R.M. can save the humanity by teaching how to reproduce properly.
But what are you doing on the laboratory's computer?
I am uploading the endocrine, reproductive, and nervous system database in order for the whole world to know how to reproduce properly. Here, let me show you the video on how to reproduce properly.
In days before fertilization, the anterior pituitary gland releases follicle-stimulating hormones, which ripens a handful of follicles in the ovary, then releases estrogen. Each follicle contains one egg, and on average, only one follicle matures and becomes an egg cell with the process of fertilization. Becomes only mature as it grows and continues to release estrogen. This hormone not only helps coordinate the growth in preparation of the uterus, but also helps the communication to the brain. When estrogen level is high enough, the anterior pituitary gland releases luteinizing hormone, which triggers the ovulation and causes follicle to rupture and release the egg cell. The egg cell then passes through the fallopian tube and it is ready for fertilization. If the egg is remained unfertilized after a certain period of time, then you'll experience menstruation. The whole process lasts for 28 days, then the process repeats itself. During puberty for males, the level of a hormone GnRH increases. The GnRH is produced in the hypothalamus. In turn, these cases of increase in production of the two hormones from part of the brain called the pituitary gland. These hormones are called the luteinizing hormone and the follicle stimulating hormone. LH in the bloodstream causes the cells in the testicles to make and release testosterone. The main male hormone, FSH and testosterone, work together to stimulate the testes to produce sperm. Each sperm cell takes between 65 to 75 days to form around 3 million and produced every day. At the top and to the back of the testicle is the epididymis, which stores the sperm. Leading from the epididymis is the vas deferens. The vas deferens carries sperm towards the penis. The mixture of the sperm and fluids from the accessory sex glands are called semen. About 2/3 of the volume of the semen come from the seminal vesicles. The semen is then passed into the urethra. When sexually aroused, a number of changes occur inside the penis. The artery supplying the penis gets bigger, allowing more blood to enter its tissues. The extra blood flow causes the penis to enlarge and become more rigid. The extra blood flow plus signals the nervous system and chemical changes causes an erection. Ejaculation is a term for the contractions that release semen. This is the reflex action, which means it is not continuously controlled. As a part of the reflex action, the opening that drains the bladder is closed. This means that urine is not released at the same time as the semen. The volume of the semen in a typical ejaculation is between 2.5 to 5 millimeters. There are normally more than 2 million sperm in each millimeter of the semen. During sexual intercourse, the penis of the male enters the vagina of the female, carrying the sperm back to the neck of the womb to fertilize the woman's egg.
Eureka! Now we know what to do to save humanity. Harvest, can you read on?
Yeah.